Hi friends, Dr. Nancy Trimbley here, putting the power and knowledge of your health back in your hands. I'm going to give you a synopsis of what Dr. Simone Gold said on a recent video that I saw. You know I'm a fan. You know, back in July, I made an audio file of the video that was pulled from the internet of the American frontline doctors when they spoke on the steps of Capitol Hill. And what I did in that video is actually a series of videos, is I broke down the audio. I put it in a different order, and then I explained what they were saying, because there was so much good information in that, things that people really needed to hear and understand. And as you know, I'm all about you becoming your own best expert related to health. So Dr. Simone Gold supports my view, and I support her, that what we're seeing with this, I'm going to use air quotes, vaccine, is really an experimental reformat. Reformat is my word, because I don't think the word vaccine describes it. So it's an experimental format. She really drilled that point home in this video, that we, as a society, we have been working on this type of reformat for decades, but we've really just missed the mark. And anybody that gets the reformat now is just part of an ongoing study. And I hope that they're gathering information from everybody that's out there that has gotten the reformat. So, first of all, if you don't watch any more of this video, I want you to do one thing for me. Go to stopmedicaldiscrimination.org and sign the petition. Sign the petition that allows us as a free society to not be coerced into having an experimental reformat done on everybody, for us to get on a plane, to work at a certain job, to go into a certain store, or whatever they decide they're going to do to coerce us. Because it is experimental. We don't know. My rule is wait at least 2 years, just put it off, and maybe 5 years would be better. We need more information on this. And as Dr. Simone Gold said, she said there is possibility that there could be what's called the pathogenic repriming, which Dr. Fauci mentioned right at the beginning when this type of reformat was when the research efforts were really ramped up. He said, well, in the preliminary studies, what happened was you give somebody this reformat, which is a messenger that goes into your body, tells your body to make something, and then your immune system attacks that. He said that when people got this reformat, and they encountered the wild virus, their body had a response and fought it off. But then the second time that they encountered the wild virus, the body overreacted and the subjects died. So there's not a good track record regarding this pathogenic repriming. Dr. Gold also mentioned the possibility of lifelong infertility. There is a question mark as to the health of the placenta when this virus is in your body. So we just don't know if the protein that's created by this messenger by your body, is that part of the problem? We don't know. There's also the autoimmune issue. Autoimmune disorders have ramped up over the last 20 to 30 years. I mentioned that in my book, Stealth Health, as to why is this happening? We don't know why it's happening, but if we have this messenger come into our body that tells our body to create this thing that then our immune system attacks, just logically, biologically, I'm thinking there's a possibility something could go awry with that. Just a possibility. Again, we just don't know. It's an experiment. So she did publish, or she did mention, guidelines for age groups regarding the experimental reformat. She said, if you're under the age of 20, your risk of getting COVID are so low, do not get the vaccine. It's strongly discouraged. For ages 20 to 50, also strongly discouraged because of you're in your childbearing age. Ages 50 to 70, She said it's slightly less than strongly discouraged. It's discouraged for sure, because again, we don't know the long-term effects. And for over age 70, they softened their recommendation a little bit. So to say, if it's something you feel like you want to do, then go ahead and get the vaccine. She also made mention of COVID-19 and the amount or the numbers of cases in Africa, and especially in the areas of Africa where the malaria preventative drug called hydroxychloroquine is given routinely. They call it the Sunday pill, and everybody has one in their pocket. They're over the counter. They take those so they do not get malaria. And she said in that area of the world, the incidences of COVID-19 are extremely low. And that deserves a look-see, don't you think? And especially when we compare that to in the United States, hydroxychloroquine was not allowed to be prescribed. The prescription would not be filled. And why? As she says, many cases of death and long-term disease could have been absolutely prevented if hydroxychloroquine would have been available in the right time. Something to really ponder as you're taking back your own power and knowledge. Something to ponder. I mean, really, we have to look at the facts. We have to look at it. In Africa, very low of COVID-19, but a high use of hydroxychloroquine. Let's see. Ivermectin is another pharmaceutical that's been used for a long time with no ill effects. And that was also scarce and hard to get in the United States. So those are the guidelines. I just wanted to pass that along, and be sure to go to stopmedicaldiscrimination.org. Sign the petition, even if you're kind of on the fence. Do you really want a government entity or a big corporation telling you that you need to do something to your body with an experimental reformat that you don't want to do right now in order to have the same rights you had a year ago? Is that what you want? I don't. So join me. All right, guys, be well. Bye for now.